Creating a complex piece like this might look really complicated, but it's actually a lot simpler than it seems using the symmetry feature in Procreate. So I'm going to show you how to use it. First, I'll create a new layer and hide the one that I was just working on. Now to set this up, we're going to go to the gear icon or the wrench icon next to gallery, and then go to canvas right here. The second option is canvas. Then we're going to turn on this drawing guide. So now this grid is going to appear on your canvas, and you can use the grid as a reference point for making your lines straight or keeping things lined up, but I'm going to show you how to make things symmetrical. So we have four options across the top. The 2D grid is the default. You can also do isometric, perspective, and then symmetry. Now for symmetry, there are four options along the bottom: horizontal, vertical, quadrant, and radial. And let's first look at horizontal. So these sliders right here will change the thickness and opacity of the actual guideline. I'm going to make it thicker so that it's easier to see. You can also change the color. I'll make it a little darker so that we can see that line. And then it's very important that you turn on assisted drawing. So you can use these guidelines here, any of these guidelines, just as a reference point in the background. But if you want the grid to help you out, you have to turn on assisted drawing. So that's what we have here. Just tap it to turn it on and off. We'll talk about rotational symmetry in a second, but for now, we're on horizontal with assisted drawing, and then we'll click done at the top to go back to our page here. So now, if we make some lines here on the canvas, you can see that it's being reflected across this guideline here onto the other side. So this is pretty cool. It's pretty fun to do. You can see that it's making a mirror image of what we're drawing here. So I'm going to write the word mirror so that we can remember this setting is creating a mirror image. Now if we go back to our drawing guides, we have to have our drawing guide on, and then to change it you just tap edit drawing guide. Now let's turn on rotational symmetry and see what happens. So turn that slider on, we'll choose a different color here, and now I'm going to write the word rotate. So you can already see the difference between what we had before was just a mirror image, but now with rotational symmetry turned on, if I turn my canvas upside down, this still says rotate because it's saying symmetrical, but the word mirror is written backwards or like it was flipped across a mirror. So that is the difference between those two settings. Let's go back to our drawing guide and turn on vertical now. So that's just gonna change it so that the line is up and down. And now it will be rotating across that line. So if I write rotate, we still have our rotational symmetry on, and so that's why it's rotating around. But if we go back to our drawing guide and turn rotational symmetry off, it will go back to being our mirror, but it will be flipping across this way. And you can write in any quadrant or in any section of this. I could be writing on this side and it will do the same thing. So that's horizontal and vertical. Now I'm going to create a new layer and hide what I was doing. So here, if I draw in here, now nothing is happening. It's not flipping across the line. That's because the layer I just created does not say assisted. So this layer we have here says assisted underneath. So right now it still has the guide on because we still have this drawing guide on. I could touch that to turn it off and now the line disappears. But on this particular layer, we don't have assisted drawing on. So if I go back to edit and then turn on assisted drawing, now we get that assistance. So I'm going to create a new layer, edit drawing guide, and let's go to quadrant this time. So here we have four quadrants. Make sure we turn on assisted drawing. And then let's see what happens here. So now we have all four quadrants are being reflected. And it's still going to have this mirror effect because we didn't turn on rotational symmetry. Let's see what happens if we go back to edit drawing guide and then rotational symmetry. Now Now if I write rotate, we can see the word rotate is still legible in any direction. So this just changes the effect of what we're seeing here. Here the design is being rotated more evenly. Here it's just being flipped across this axis and then this axis like a mirror. So that just completely changes the look. If you were making some spirals or something, if you have rotational symmetry on, that's what it would look like. If we turn rotational symmetry off and made the same kind of spiral, it would just give it a different look. So now I'm going to add a new layer, and again, if we add a new layer and it doesn't have that assistance on, we have to go turn it on. Another way of doing that is just by duplicating your layer and then clearing the contents of it, and then it will keep the assisted drawing on if you want to keep the same type of grid. But now we're going to look at the radial option here. So now we have 8 sections. And you can change where the midpoint is using that dot, or you can also change how much it's rotated. So if you don't want it to be straight up and down, you could rotate it like this. So let's leave rotational symmetry off here. And again, we can see this mirrored effect without rotational symmetry on. Turn it back on. So you can go back and forth between these effects to change what it looks like. You can also go back and forth between your type of guide. So if I next wanted it to just be a quadrant instead, you can change it to quadrant, and then it would do it only 4 times instead of 8. So now it only has 4, and these guides will still show up even if you turn off the assisted drawing, so that if you just wanted something in one spot, you could do that. And then to completely hide the guide, you just turn the drawing guide off. So I'll just create one more layer, turn my drawing guide back on. Let's make it radial. Make sure the assisted drawing is on. Maybe I'll choose a different pen. And then let's just make some fun shapes here. It's kind of fun to watch these patterns appear, and it's almost hard to tell what's about to happen. Kind of have to get used to it. You can write some words, make some designs. If we go back to the original design that I had here, let me turn off my guide so it's not blocking anything. But from far away, it might just look like a design. But if you look up close, it actually has the word symmetry hidden in here. There's the S, Y, symmetry, and then I made the RY at the bottom to kind of fill up some more of the space. And so I can tell from here that I was using the mirror, or I turned rotational symmetry off, because if you rotate it around, sometimes it's showing up backward. So that is a brief introduction to how to use the symmetry tool in Procreate.